I already made a video on how to install Dolphin on Windows and macOS, and I asked if you wanted to see a guide for Android. Many of you did, so here it is, the guide for Dolphin emulator on Android, which actually works pretty good. First of all, I do want to mention you do need a pretty powerful system for this. A Snapdragon 845 or higher really is recommended, so make sure your system can actually handle this because lower end systems will struggle. So first we are going to download the Dolphin emulator. You might know it is always on the Play Store, and I actually don't recommend downloading it from this. I recommend going to the Chrome site and then go to dolphinemu.org. Here simply click the download button right here. Scroll down and download the latest development version for Android. So click Android and download it. Now let it download and it could take a while. Click open and you can install this app. If you have never installed a .apk before, it will say you need to enable downloads from untrusted sources. So just click it and check the setting and then you should be able to install this. If it will say your device is not supported or app did not install, make sure to check if your device is 32-bit. If it is, it will not work because Dolphin on Android only works on 64-bit systems. Now click install and let it install. If it is done, you can click open. And the first thing it asks if it can use the media. Click allow because we do want to actually use this. And now you can configure all these settings. Also, it will say if it can use the usage statistics. It is really up to you. You can press yes or no. I'm just going to click yes. So let's cover all these settings. First, we are going to use the general settings. And right here, most of these should be at stock. In the general, you can change some stuff. And one thing I really do want to mention is the override emulated CPU clock speed. As said already, you do need a quite powerful system, preferably Snapdragon 845 or higher, but you can enable this and lower the emulated clock speed to like 60 or 40%, and this might increase the performance. Note this isn't some magical trick and not all systems will be playable using this, but if you put it to something like 60%, it might perform a bit better. So you can click OK, and then that could help in performance on some games. For now, I'm going to just disable this. Again, change it if your performance is bad. For the rest of the stuff, I recommend changing it at the default and click save. Now there are some other settings like the interface. We don't need to change this. The path, we also don't need to change this right now. And the GameCube and Wii stuff, again, we don't have to change this. You can insert something in the GameCube slot, which actually can be pretty useful, like a memory card. But for now, let's keep it at the default. For the Wii, also at the default. And for debug, don't mess with this because that's for debug only. Now let's move on to the graphical settings, where there are some juicy settings to change. So first, for the video backend, you can use either OpenGL or Vulkan. And it depends on your device and on the game if it works good or not. For me, I'm going to try out Vulkan, but try both and see which works best for you. I also want to enable the show FPS. This is up to you, but I like to see what FPS the game is running at. For the shader compilation mode, this actually is pretty complex. For me, I am going to use synchronous, and there are two other things which you could try. If there are many stutters in the game, you could try asynchronous Uber shaders, and this will have some graphics popping in, but it should reduce the stutter. You can also use asynchronous skip drawing. And if you enable this, the stutters might get even less, but there will be objects popping in as they compile the shaders. I recommend using synchronous or asynchronous Uber shaders. For me, I'm going to stick with synchronous for this video. But again, you might want to test both and see which works best for you. I also always recommend to compile shaders before starting. This will cause a small delay when launching the game, but it will reduce stutter. For the aspect ratio, use auto. Do not use any of the force options. We can also check out the enhancements, and here we can change some things to make the game look better. You can change the internal resolution, the anti-aliasing and the filtering. All of these can be cranked up all the way to 4K and even higher maybe. But I don't recommend doing this because we are still using a phone and the internals aren't that powerful. So you could try something like 2 or 3 times native and the performance might be decent. But for me, I want the best performance, so I'm going to stick with the default settings. All the way at the bottom, there also is something called backend multithreading. And this could increase performance if you're using Vulkan. Again, it might not work great, and it says right here, if ensure leave is unchecked, but you could try it out and see how it affects performance. The last thing we're going to check is the hex, and here most of these should be enabled for the EFB settings. So if you check all these, most games should still work fine, and the performance might be a bit better if all of these are enabled. Make sure to check the game's wiki page if you're experiencing some graphical issues, because sometimes one of these does need to be disabled. But for most games, this is fine. For the accuracy, change the low to the for the best performance. And for some phones that have a really great GPU but bad CPU, you might want to enable GPU texture decoding. But for most systems, maybe if you're on the Switch, this is not the case. But for most systems, leave this disabled. Next, all of these should be at the stock settings. And again, click save once you're done. Now let's go over to the controls. So first we got the Xbox controller right here. And if you press one, you can see you can disable the controller, emulate it, and use a GameCube adapter. If you're using a real GameCube controller, you can use the adapter. But for us, we are using another controller, which is just connected via Bluetooth. So you can click Emulator and here map all the controls. Simply click it and then click the button on your controller to bind it. For me, I just binded it to my volume rockers because that's just a quick way to show that it does work. Now click Save. And now we're going to actually edit the Wiimote controls. And here again, click the first Wiimote and here you can see options. Disabled, emulated, and you can use a real Wiimote, although this does require the Dolphin bar to be connected. So we are going to click emulated and the same stuff applies. Click a button and then map it to your controller. There's one thing, which are the extensions, and here you can try all of these controllers, which actually might be better. For example, the nunchuck is required for many games. Once you're done, again, click save, and we are pretty much good to go to open games. So first, with the refresh library and open file we are not going to use, we're going to press the little plus in the bottom and then scroll all the way down to where we sort all our ROMs. So for me, I got it in ROMs and then in Wii. And then right here, you can see we got the ISO. We want to select this directory and you can see my game does show up right here. So to open it, you can simply click it and it should open up. As you can see, I got all controls on screen right now, which is pretty great. Let's press yes so it can create the save data. And if you pull down, you can see here some options. You can here configure the controls, which is pretty useful. You can edit the layout so you can move around the buttons. You can toggle them, adjust the scale, add rumble and all kinds of stuff. And there are many more settings like this. You can also change the screen orientation to portrait. Change the disk as needed, and of course, exit the program. But for now, I am going to show some gameplay of Super Smash Bros. Melee, and I am going to blur the gameplay because Nintendo will take down my guides if I'm not careful. But I really hope this guide was very useful and you did get some games booting up with some great performance. If you did, make sure to let me know by leaving a like down below. Comment what you thought of it, and if you have any issues, make sure to ask in the comments below or in my Discord, on Twitter, on Facebook, pretty much anywhere. I will be available and I will try to react to all comments if possible. So I hope you enjoyed it, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.